In the summer of 2019, the internet was extremely pleased to see a trailer for the upcoming XXXTentacion documentary. There was no release date given, but 2020 was given as a release window for the upcoming project. 2020 came and went with not only no documentary, but also little to no info on when to expect it. Now here we are in 2021, basically in the same spot as we were a year and a half ago. So what happened to XXXTentacion's documentary? As we get into this video, I want to mention that I'm going to be heavily referencing the Pitchfork article that was written in December of 2019. It details what the documentary was originally meant to be and how the project fell into the state it's in now. If you'd like to read the full article for yourself, which I'd highly recommend that you do, I'll leave a link down in the description below. The original X documentary was started back in early 2017 when X was in jail awaiting trial for charges of home invasion robbery and aggravated battery with a firearm. The project was headed up by the Faders Robert Semmer and Scott Perry. The original goal for the documentary was to answer the question, can you separate the art from the artist? At this point in time, X was right on the verge of entering superstardom, so it was truly a perfect time to begin capturing the story of XXXTentacion. In the spring of 2017, the Fader team was in Florida to document X's release from jail and what his life was looking like now that he was a semi-free man. Remember folks, X was sitting in jail as his name was really beginning to pop off. So when he got out, he was quickly greeted by the new fame that had been waiting for him all that time. Besides the tag-along footage that Fader got while following him around, they also got separate interviews with X himself and his ex-girlfriend, Geneva Ayala. In mid-2017, Semmer presented what he had so far for the documentary to the Fader staff back in New York. The project was only about 20 minutes long at the time, and its mission was presenting both sides of the story and allowing people to make their own conclusion. The staff recognized that the documentary tried very hard not to pick sides in the messy situation between X and Ayala, but because of that, it made X seem like a sympathetic character. It was assumed that people did not and would not feel comfortable with the project if it portrayed X like a sympathetic character. With this feedback, Semmer made changes to the documentary, which we would assume changed the tone to favor more of Geneva Ayala's side of things. After the changes were made, the project was fairly close to being finished, so in order to fulfill a promise made earlier in the project's production, the documentary was shown to X's team. As you can imagine, they did not care for how the documentary had turned out. They wanted Ayala cut out of the project entirely, to which Semmer declined to do. After X's team basically tried to physically threaten Semmer, they threatened legal action next. And because of that, that XXXTentacion documentary was put away. In the summer of 2018, X was killed, and shortly after that, the Fader team that was working on the original project were told that X's estate was now working on his documentary. A year later, X's estate released the trailer for the documentary that they had been working on for the past year. The problem was that basically all of the footage that was shown in the trailer was from the footage that Semmer's team had shot when they were with X back in 2017. And that trailer, the trailer we got on the 1 year anniversary of X's death, is really the last legit piece of content we got when it comes to the XXXTentacion documentary. Since then, Fader has gone through pretty major personnel changes and it's become very unclear on their involvement with the project at this point in time. In late 2019, X's estate will continue to preserve his legacy with a documentary set to release in 2020. So going a bit off subject here for a moment, what exactly is an estate? It's basically a person or group of people that manage someone else's assets, usually upon death. In X's case, his estate is more or less made up of his mother and his record label. That's who's been making the decisions on his behalf and managing his brand since his death. As many of you probably know, a lot of the diehard X fans are not exactly pleased with how his estate has handled his brand since his death. They don't feel like X would have released either one of his posthumous albums, Skins, and Bad Vibes Forever, at least not in the state that we received them in. A lot of his diehard fans think his entire image has been ruined since his death. I don't think his estate has ruined his image, but I don't think it's in the greatest place right now. The overall brand of XXXTentacion is being presented as more of just a woke pop star. But even with that being said, I don't think X's brand could really be handled well by anyone except X himself. XXXTentacion was truly a one-of-a-kind artist, and no one really knew what was going on within his mind. But for anyone who's trying to maintain that image and play his next move on his behalf, they're doomed to fail. Keep in mind that one of the last major things X did before he was killed was sign a $10 million record deal with Capitol Music. His estate still has to carry out whatever the terms of that deal was to the best of their ability. So try and go easy on his team. Now back to the documentary. Now, I don't have any new info on when we should expect this release. I mean, who am I anyway? You can be hopeful that 2021 is the year we get this doc, but I'm here to try and give you guys a different perspective to look at the situation from. I know a lot of people are skeptical of how this documentary is going to turn out because of all the twists and turns the production took and because of how X's estate has handled everything else so far. But even with that being said, a lot of those same people take the delayed release of this documentary as another misstep by X's estate. But I'm looking at it as a big blessing. Eventually, there won't be any new content to release from X. And that will be that. We don't get any new music or videos from, say, Tupac or Biggie, because whatever posthumous stuff they had left laying around has been released long, long ago. And until the end of time, we're left just wondering what could have been. So imagine how massive it would be if a Tupac documentary full of never-before-seen footage was announced to release next month, all these years later. The world would go nuts for it. Our society has a much greater appreciation for entertainment years after it's faded into the background. Remember when The Last Dance was finally released last summer? Do you think it would have gotten the same amount of hype if it was released just a year after the Bulls dynasty came to an end back in the 90s? No. If X's estate really wants to preserve his legacy, they'll wait as long as possible to release this documentary, and I'm completely okay with that. This documentary could very well be the final thing we get from X, so I'd rather save that for much further down the road. Thanks for watching this episode of What Happened To. I'm currently working on a much longer project that's going to unpack the business side of how record deals actually work in the rap industry. In the meantime, be sure to check out my What Happened To playlist, where I take a look at what other actors and artists are up to now that they faded away from the spotlight. And if you're into sports, I'd highly appreciate it if you check out the weekly sports podcast I do with my good friend Shaq. We go live every Wednesday night at 9 p.m. Eastern Time here on YouTube and talk about the latest in the NFL and NBA. The link to that channel is in the description below. If you enjoyed this video, be sure to hit the like button and also subscribe to my channel so you can keep up with all my new content. Thanks for watching until the end. It really does mean a lot. Peace. And also subscribe to my channel so you can keep up with all... If you endure... Jesus.